Hey folks, Michael Phillips here. Welcome to Real Thursdays. And today I'm here to tell you and you and you too, pal, about the latest from Woody Allen, Denzel Washington, and Mark Wahlberg. That's two different movies, by the way. First up, Blue Jasmine is Woody Allen's latest, and the 77-year-old writer-director approaches this phase of his filmmaking career the same way he's worked most of his life. If you don't like this one, don't worry, he's already shooting the next one. This is a half-serious study, serio-comic, let's say, of a woman past the verge of a socioeconomic and psychological breakdown. The woman's played by Cate Blanchett, who surely will snag an Oscar nomination for this performance, I think. She plays a Park Avenue socialite whose husband, Weasel, played by Alec Baldwin, goes to prison for his shifty, Bernie Madoff-like investment activity. Now, Jasmine's sister is a San Francisco cashier, played by Sally Hawkins, and she's the one who takes her sister in at a time of need. Promptly, Jasmine starts in with her Blanche DuBois crazy woman act, and Allen's script does exactly the same thing. Blue Jasmine owes a lot, and I mean a lot, to Tennessee Williams' Streetcar Named Desire. On balance, I'd say it's worth seeing because of the acting, and not just for Blanchett. Among others, there's a really good performance, very subtle too, by Andrew Dice Clay, of all people, as one of the sister's exes. I'll have to leave it to others, though, to declare Blue Jasmine one of Allen's peak recent achievements, along with the ones I really like, Match Point, Vicky Cristina Barcelona, and Midnight in Paris. Then again, it might just be a simple fact of me having seen A Streetcar Named Desire too many times. Maybe I just couldn't get the sound of Williams' poetry out of my head long enough to take Allen's variation on that theme for what it is or is not. Okay, next film, Two Guns. Guess what? There's a lot of gunplay in the new Denzel Washington, Mark Wahlberg action movie, Two Guns. And there's banter, too. Roll the clip.
You kidnapped a drug kingpin.
That's correct.
Poppy Greco, and you tied him up in my garage.
Sorry, what do you mean?
Would you mind if I swipe a yogurt?
Yeah, sure. Please, help yourself to anything. Take whatever you want.
It's just a yogurt.
Yeah, but it's her yogurt. Just put it back. Please.
What are you two like, ex-boyfriend and girlfriend?
Actually, you know what? We never put a name on it.
Oh, so what? You broke his heart or he broke yours?
Wow, this guy will really ask anyone anything at any time.
Bobby,
what do you see in this guy?
I could go on for hours, but I don't know you. I don't think this is the right time for us to have this conversation, okay?
So, daddy issues, huh?
Daddy!
Is he serious?
Garage.
I knew it.
Poppy.
Hey, daddy.
Go.
I go. Get it now. Go to the garage. Oh, can I have the yogurt?
You can have the yogurt.
Yes.
Here.
I don't like her, man.
Well, you don't get a vote.
I'm watch.
Pretty decent stuff, thanks to the stars and to such supporting weasels. Weasels all over the place this week. As Bill Paxton, as a CIA operative, who's after $43 million in stolen drug money. Edward James Olmos is the cartel bigwig with similar taste in hats as the Paxton characters, also after the money. Washington and Wahlberg, which I believe is a new stop on the CTA Blue Line, play different breeds of undercover ops, getting double-crossed and then getting even. But who would have thunk that Two Guns would have so much in common with Blue Jasmine? Figure this out. Both movies are about characters hung out to dry with the people they trust the most. Both movies, uneven and flawed, are saved in the end by their respective marquee performers. The acting, I think, is usually the least of a movie's problems. And sometimes actors can make a movie more of a movie than it really is. Now, three to see. The Conjuring is number one. Classy, restrained, a seriously scary haunted house thriller. Fruitvale Station, number two. This is a gripping true story of the last day in the life of a young man killed on an Oakland, California train platform. The film made the top 10 in the nation's box office last week. It's amazing considering the modest number of theaters it's playing, but it's also completely understandable given the word of mouth, which is excellent, on Ryan Coogler's feature film debut. And for number three, what the hey, I'll go with The Wolverine, a better than usual franchise number in the apparently inexhaustible series of movies made under the Marvel Comics banter. Two to avoid? Well, that's pretty easy. The Lone Ranger, number one. I'm still scraping the dung off my boots thanks to that one. And number two, Monsters University, a disappointing sequel from Pixar. And one to remember. So three to see, two to avoid, one to remember. There's a revival of the Jim Jarmusch Western Dead Man, starring Johnny Depp in a much better Western than The Lone Ranger. This features a wonderful, very spare musical score by Neil Young. It's playing 7:30 Monday only at the Patio Theater on West Irving Park Road. and it's a presentation of the Northwest Chicago Film Society. You can count on the best available prints to be shown from this group. Go to Chicago, go to this website, northwestchicagofilmsociety.org, for more information. So that's it. See you next week for Real Thursdays and the Chicago Tribune. I'm Michael Phillips.